Simmering tensions have been mounting in the Bunyoro region ever since the Parliamentary Probe Committee visited the exploration area 3 days ago. Kingdom officials and locals are angry with the government for what they call neglect of their region on issues of oil exploration.
They have not consulted us, they have not used us. And that's why His Majesty is very grateful that you have come here. Because we have the information, the people come here telling the king.
The Omukama of Bunyoro Kingdom, King Gafabusa Iguru, today warned that he would sue the government of Uganda for tampering with Bunyoro mineral resources without consulting him. King Iguru told the probe committee chairman, Michael Werike, this morning that the oil companies could be operating illegally on his land without his authority.
Nobody should come to Bunyoro Kingdom to do anything, even to acquire the land, without consulting Bunyoro Kingdom. And it was signed.
And we have copies of those.
We have all the copies, yes. You see. So those people who are down there are illegal. If we take them to court, to international court, they are not supposed to be there.
The king is citing the 1955 agreement his forefathers signed with the British colonial government as the basis for his case. The agreement bars anybody from tampering with Bunyoro resources until the king gives his consent.
Before you really talk about oil, you must talk to His Highness, the king of Bunyoro.
That was the 1955 agreement.
Yes.
It was never done. We were supposed to be consulted. That was 1955 agreement. It is still valid.
Or with the colonial people?
Yes.
However, legal minds argue that the colonial agreement was nullified by Uganda's constitutions that were drafted after independence. In 2001, the Omukama attempted to sue the British government but was advised against it because it was feared the act would have reduced Uganda's chances of hosting the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting in Kampala. King Iguru is demanding to interact more with the legislators so that the historical injustices that he says were caused by colonialists in Bunyoro are settled once and for all.
And I would like this information to go through Parliament, so that people can know.
Earlier, the king demanded that the 12% of royalties from the oil and gas sector be remitted to his kingdom.
We don't know. A lot of things have not been done properly. The kingdom was supposed to, in the olden days, was getting royalty. There is no royalty anymore.
Meanwhile, the committee today met Bunyoro members of parliament together with civil society groups and accused security officials of labeling them as rebels with the intention to sabotage the oil project.
We request for a 10% share of the oil revenues to be shared amongst the regional government and the district local governments.
The local leaders and the civic organs have gone ahead to make reports to the office of the president that we are recruiting rebels, which is not true.
Tempers on oil matters in Bunyoro seem to be high, and the community feels that they have been denied a chance to participate in their God-given resource. This calls for government intervention before the situation gets out of hand. Jingo Francis, NTV, Hoima.